a seat so that we give light to the world. As you come out today, you will be the light of the world. Amen. That document I've not seen you before we begin to see you. Amen. That good things that have not been locating you before we begin to locate you. Amen. That husband that have not locating you before we locate you. Amen. That children that have not locating you before we begin to locate you. Amen. But when something is darkness, you cannot do what good things cannot locate it. But when light comes, everybody's located. And from today, your light will shine. Good thing will locate you. Good thing will locate our children. Good thing will locate every living churches in the whole world. In Jesus' name. We are still going to pray for every country when there is world. We are going to pray for the light of God to shine upon those lands when there is war. When you see the one in the land, please don't rejoice and say, he has not come to my city. While I now stand to pray for the city, and you thought that it's not your own city, and there is a parable my grandmother used to say in those days. When we are talking about war, he will say, shut up, don't say it. The month when they say war, you need to do what? To worship. Don't open your mouth. Why? Because Opuo Emosi, hallelujah, saying that war is not a beautiful thing for you to do what? To experience. Amen. You see children, more than running for their own work, for their own sake, abandoning their children. We are going to stand on our feet, to stand in the camp, to pray for the country when there is war. Amen. How many of us have been looking television? Let me say by hand. Yeah. Can you tell me the name of the country where there is war? How many of you have prayed? Amen. Hallelujah. How many of us have come across it and begin to pray? And we are going to stand on our feet to pray. First, we are going to ask God for mercy. And what's our motto? He says, Ezekiel 22, verse 30. He said, the Lord says he sought for a man among them that will make up the hedge and stand in the gap before him for the land so that he will not destroy it. And today, the children have told us that we are the light of the world. Father, you have found us. We will stand in the gap to pray for that city when there is war, so that the light of God will come upon that land, so that that land will have peace. Amen. Before we go into prayer, we are going to ask God for mercy. Because we don't know what causes the war. Amen. Something happened in those days in the Bible, in the land of Sodom and Gomorrah. And when the Lord afflicted that land, and he destroyed the land because of their words, the atrocity. We are going to pray that any land when there is war, that they have done something wrong, and have made God to allow those wells to come into that land to destroy that city. We are going to ask God for mercy. Open your mouth and begin to ask God for mercy. Ask God for mercy. Father, have mercy, Lord, oh God. Every land, oh Lord, where there is war. Father, Lord, King of glory. Whatever that they have done, oh Lord, wherever they have turned their back against you, Lord, oh God. Because your word says, oh Lord, except you wash over the city, a washman washes in vain. Father, Lord, King of glory. Whatever that makes you, Lord, not to wash over that city, that men want to penetrate. Father, we are asking for mercy, Lord. Father, we are asking for mercy, Lord. According to your word, O Lord, in Ezekiel 22, verse 30, when we come to stand, O Lord, in the car, as a light, O Lord, O God. Father, Lord, so that you will not destroy that land. Father, Lord, we are here, O Lord, O God. Father, mercy, Lord. Mercy, Lord. Mercy, Lord. Have mercy upon Nigeria. Have mercy upon Lord of God. Every country where there is war. Have mercy. Have mercy. And let your light shine in the authority name of Jesus. We are still going to pray to Almighty God. Before we go into this prayer, there is a song a father taught us yesterday. And we are going to sing this song in Benin, also in English, so that those who does not understand the Nigeria, the Benin dialect, we also understand their English one. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. And the song goes like this. It's the Lord, and the songs we are taking from Matthew 7:7. Amen. When you know, when you know, when you know, please, if I'm not pronouncing it well, the one who taught us the music is here, who can help us.
All the time.
Amen and amen. Please, if you know that as you are the usher in the house, please don't just wait behind, don't rush home. You know what? We are using this opportunity also to invite everyone to join us with the usher. We are doing what? Our day, which is next week, Sunday. Amen. Hallelujah. God says that, oh, na so so program. And they do for this church. Now the church will light day. Amen. And light for the shine. Hallelujah, somebody. Amen. It's to tell you that the light of God is shining upon our life. Please and please join us, the usher. We have our day. As you do, God Almighty, we bless everyone of us in Jesus' name. Amen.